हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ मिसेस कीर्ति प्रमोद सपारे, सीनियर लेक्चरर एट एमसी सोसाइटीज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी पुणे। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ फॉर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। लेट्स स्टार्ट लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। फ्रॉम दिस वीडियो स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन साइलेंट फीचर्स, एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ जॉइंट स्टॉक कंपनी एंड कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी। Reflection spot, that is question for the students. Classify different forms of business organization. Pause this video, write the answer of this question in your notebook and play the video once you have done. Classification, which we have already discussed. Forms of organization are of two types, non-corporate, that is sole proprietorship, partnership and joint into family business, which we have already discussed in the last video. And now we are going to see corporate forms of business organization, that is joint stock company and cooperative society. Let's start with joint stock company. Joint stock company, it is governed by Company Act and it has to follow various provisions of the Act. It is organized to carry on a business on a large scale because its capital requirement and risk obligations are too burdensome for a single individual or few individuals to bear themselves. Joint stock company is an organization of individuals for gaining profit in which capital is divided into transferable shares. Silent features of joint stock company. Registration. A company requires registration under the Company Act 1956. Running of business. Business is run by the board of directors elected by the members in the general body meeting of the company. Members or owners. The members or shareholders are the owner of the company. Capital. Investors can invest small or large sums as per their wish. Continuity. Company will continue till the minimum number of members are there. Withdrawal by shareholder. A shareholder is always free to withdraw by transferring his shares. Legal person. Company is a legal person. Its life does not depend on the life of members. Limited liability. Liability of each member is limited. Common seal. A company cannot sign document for itself. A common seal is used as a substitute for signature. Advantages and disadvantages of joint stock company. Let's start with advantages. Capital. Capital can be collected in a large amounts. Management. Company is managed by board of directors who are elected by shareholders. Thus, the major policy decisions are taken by shareholders. Existence of company. Insolvency, insanity or death of members has no effect. Risk per persons. It is reduced because it is diffuse and spread over several members of the company. Qualified and experienced personnel. Company can appoint well-qualified and experienced personnel to run the business, which helps the management to earn increasing profits. Transferable shares. Shares can be transferred easily and encashed easily. Flat rate taxation. Company pays income tax at a flat rates. Disadvantages. Formation of company is a costly and time-consuming process. Legal formalities. Large number of legal formalities are required to form joint stock company. Control by board of directors. Company is managed by board of directors who have no personal interest. Therefore, there is no incentive for them to manage the company more efficiently. misuse a position. Directors sometimes misuse their position and serve their own personal ends, ignoring the interest of shareholders. Decision. No prompt decision can be taken because of time lag between the meetings. Cheating may be happen. Exploitation of consumers may be happen by excessive pricing and poor quality goods. Secrecy cannot be maintained. Next, different types of joint stock company. Companies may be classified from four different points of view. First, on the basis of incorporation. Chartered company, statutory company, and registered company. Chartered company formed during 17th and 18th century by passing special charter known as Royal Charter. Charter, that is agreement. This company does not exist in India. Example, East India Company. Second type, that is statutory company. It is established by passing a special act of parliament. It is formed to run the public utility concerns like railways, water, gas, electricity, etc. Example, LIC, Air India, the Reserve Bank of India are statutory companies. Registered company. These companies are very important. They are registered under Companies Act. The rules and regulations regarding its formation, working and continuity of the company are mentioned in the relevant Companies Act. Second classification, from the point of view of liabilities. Companies with unlimited liabilities, companies with limited liability by guarantee and limited liability by shares. Company with unlimited liability. These are same as a sole proprietorship. That is, each member has unlimited liability. In the case of winding up of the company, the private property of the members can be taken over for recovery of dues. Company with limited liability by guarantee. Liability of members is limited to the specific amount guaranteed by them. If the company is wound up, then members have to repay fixed amount guaranteed by them. Then company with limited liability by shares. Liability of members is limited by the value of their shares. If the company is wound up, then members will have to repay amount equal to their shares. Third, from the point of view of nationality. National companies and multinational companies. National companies operate within the boundary of country and multinational company operate in the various parts of worlds. And last, from the point of view of public interest, and this is most important classification. Private company, public company and government company. Private company run by minimum 2 or maximum 50 members and does not allow public subscription to its share. These companies also restrict the transfer of their shares. Public companies, companies which are run by minimum 7 members and having no maximum limit on its member. They offer its shares to the public with the view to collect large amount of money. These companies does not restrict members for transfer of their shares. Government company, at least 51% of paid up capital is held by central government, state government or partially by central and state government both. Next, last form of business organization, that is cooperative societies. It is a voluntary organization of persons who are financially strong with the aim not to get profits but to overcome destability arising out of want of adequate financial resources, or with the aim not to earn the profit but to uplift weaker sections of the society. It is registered under Indian Cooperative Society Act 1912. The goods produced by such societies are sold in the market. The profit earned by distributing is distributed among the members of the society as a dividend by the company. Salient features. First is registration. It requires registration under Cooperative Society Act 1912. Voluntary organization. It is voluntary organization made by association of persons and not of capital. A member can withdraw from a society by giving due notice. Management. Management is done by the managing committee, which is elected by the members of society, which frames the policies and manages affairs of the society. Capital. Capital contributed by its member through the purchase of shares by loans from central or state cooperative banks. Shares of the society cannot be transferred to others, but they can be returned to the company or to the society. Distribution of profit. It is not related to the capital contribution. Criteria for profit distribution is the value or volume of business transferred by each member. Working pattern. It is on a cash basis and not on credit basis. And liability of the member is limited. Advantages and disadvantages of cooperative society. First, we will start with advantages. Association. Voluntary association formed by any 10 adult persons. Legal requirements. Only few legal formalities are required. Management. It is based on the principle of one man, one vote basis. There is no discrimination on the basis of number of shares held by the members. Coordination is seen as all the members belongs to one local area or a particular class or group. Balance in the profit. It is utilized for the growth and development of the society. Government facility. State government offers many types of facilities like loans at a low interest rate and grants several exemptions and reliefs besides low tax rate. Membership. Membership is open to everybody. There is no limit on capital investment. There is a no discrimination, no casteism, etc. Disadvantages. Shortage of capital. There is always shortage of capital. No efficiency, as society is managed by managing committee who generally lacks the technical knowledge and experience. No secrecy, as members are more. Excessive state regulations on the company, so working is affected. Lack of motivation, because rate of return to the member is limited by the law, and there is a competition between the members due to differences in opinion. Thank you very much.